И также присоединяюсь, пользуясь случаем, поздравлением премьер-министра Индии. Поздравляю господина премьер-министра Индии Нарендру Моди с днем рождения. Хочу пожелать вам, дорогой друг, крепкого здоровья, всяческих успехов. Символично, что юбилейное заседание ШОС проходит в Душанбе, об этом уже тоже говорил, где в июле
2016 This organization was established and it has been 20 years since it has been successfully operating. SCO is rightfully one of the most powerful, influential centers for multipolar international cooperation. It contributes significantly in ensuring Eurasian security, its sustainable economic growth and support to international peace and stability overall. At the moment, our organizations are faced with the task of conducting a common and aligned, based on the risk-oriented, involving the situation in Afghanistan after a fast withdrawal of USA and NATO forces from this country. As we all understand, the events in Afghanistan have a direct impact on the security of SCO countries. And moreover, a number of our countries have common borders with Afghanistan. I would like to believe that, first of all, we need to benefit of the capacity of SCO to ensure a global collaboration in the Afghan peaceful process and try our best in order to block any threats emerging from this country, including terrorism, drug trafficking, and religious extremism. Indeed, the change of power in Afghanistan has happened bloodlessly, which is a very positive import. Talibs are controlling almost nearly entire territory of Afghanistan, and that's why it's important to stimulate new Afghan authorities to follow up with their commitments on providing stability, security to all, and inclusiveness. And to that extent, it's important to work on renewing cooperation, coordination of the contact group of SCO Afghanistan that was about to set up earlier. The algorithm of joint efforts on timely response to the threat from Afghan territory has been discussed yesterday during the collective security meeting of SCOT. And yes, we are indeed interested to make sure that the decisions made in the session will be supported by our SCO partners. That's why I believe that it's very important and crucial and useful to go on with the initiative of a joint meeting of SCO and SCTO, which provide us an opportunity to discuss in details the practical cooperation between the two organizations on the Afghan issue. It's important to ensure a coordination given the authorities of SCO and CSTO. And as for the cooperation, direct cooperation within the SCO, I believe it would be useful to improve functional capacities of anti-terrorist structure through integrating into its resources the experts on money laundering, on financing terrorism and proliferation of mass destruction weapons. I'd like to highlight that Russia will be involved proactively in the activities of the cooperation program of SCO in countering terrorism, extremism, and that for 2022-2024. The action plan on implementing anti-drug strategy of SCO for the period until 23, and the action plan on ensuring international information security for 2023, and with all the emphasis that is required in and which is emerging in our common space, the other set of issues are equally vital, including strengthening our partnership relations in the social and economic fields. Coronavirus pandemic, which has been just described by colleagues, resulted in decreasing international trade, instigated the anxiety in the financial market, and the crisis of world economy caused increase in unemployment, poverty level, which had an impact on economic relations between SCO countries. Since last year, the volume of mutual trade of Russia with SCO countries plummeted to 6.4% from 41 billion USD. However, there is I'm positive that we can alter the situation and take this cooperation back to its initial level and even strengthen it further through the anti-crisis measures that are underway by all our countries. Russia has forwarded about 3 billion rubles, which is equivalent to 4.5 GDP of Russia, to retain jobs and incomes of population, to support business, to restart the investment cycle, and provide assistance to the regions, to families, households, and the key instrument for further stimulation of economic growth involves digitalization and wider use of environmentally clean technologies and other solutions in all areas of economy, including public management, transport. On all these areas, SCO member countries have improved a collaboration which should be further promoted. The resource saving areas, the so-called Green Belt program of SCO, and an action plan on practical implementation of the concept of cooperation concept on environment for the period from 22 to 24. I'd like to highlight the role of SCO in restoring the dynamic of economic cooperation amid coronavirus pandemic, which played a comprehensive plan in countering the pandemic, which was timely established last year during the summit of SCO during the Russian chairmanship. It's important to mention that implementation of this plan is actively underway, and each country of SCO is involved. I'd like to mention that Russia donated to the member states the tests for 1.2 million for the research of COVID-19, and we continue sharing our experts and scientists to support our partners. We invited representatives of SCO to the international the trainings of the rapid response team to the epidemic, which will be conducted in Russia, in Kazan this October. Russia stands for the further expansion, the legal framework of SCO, and one of the significant steps towards that is approving the decision of SCO member state in cooperation in the area of cultural legacy and heritage in the field of culture in general, and in tourism and in terms of tourism and cultural center of SCO. Dear friends, we give much emphasis to the cooperation of SCO countries with those states that are striving to have an improved and active dialogue with our countries and seek involvement. And in that sense, Russia is supporting the decision of SCO countries on the procedure of inviting Islamic Republic of Iran in the membership of SCO. We have already been standing for the full format involvement of Iran in the activities of this organization. This country plays an important role in the Eurasian region and has been already fruitfully cooperating with SCO since a long time. Iran's inclusion will contribute in improving the credibility of SCO in the future going forward. And we are welcoming also Egypt, Qatar, Saudi Arabia as a, in the status of a partner to the dialogue. Russia is standing for engaging these countries in the dialogue. And indeed, the most serious focus should be given to an entire portfolio of applications by other countries willing to cooperate with SCO in the different formats. We believe it's important to think how to modernize and provide a higher performance for the our partners to participate in this format. It would be a benefit in parallel with our other summits, of SCO summits, to conduct top level activities under the SCO Plus format through engaging our partners. And also, I would like to highlight the memorandum to be signed today on the new understanding between the SCO and Eurasian Economic Commission, which is in line with implementation of Russian idea of establishing a greater Eurasian partnership with SCO countries, Eurasian countries, ASEAN, and the Chinese initiative One Belt, One Path. And I believe that integration of all of these ideas that take shape in Eurasia towards a developing and open mutually beneficial cooperation will be in line with interests of all our respective countries. In conclusion, dear friends, I would like to once again appreciate Mr. Emomali Sharipovich Rahmonov for the organizing this effort, and I would like to wish him best of success to the Shavkat, to the President of Uzbekistan, Mr. Mirziyoyev, for the transition of presidency of SCO to Uzbekistan. Thank you.